Hello and welcome. Have you ever wanted to play Fortnite in a box with a fox? Well, good news, because you are today. That's right, it's time to learn about the game mode, Box Fight, starring the absolutely adorable Fenix. As the name implies, this is a game mode where you have to get a little cozy with your opponent. Not that cozy. The basic setup for a box fight is to start by creating an enclosed area of any size. From there, you'll need to add a few player spawns for your players and a barrier to stop them from attacking each other at the start, which will let them gear up to fight. How you go from there depends on what type of box fight you want to set up and how creative you want to make it for your players and spectators. You can adjust the speed at which your matches will play out by changing the player count and team size. You adjust player count here, and then team size right here. You can design your island to be a 1v1 box fight match, or maybe have smaller teams that have to cooperate to take down their opponents. You can even have multiple arenas with different players fighting simultaneously. When designing your box fight, you can mix in other gameplay types, for example, a shrinking zone like in Battle Royale, or add traps players need to build around. The size of the box, or the area your players will be fighting in, is one of the most important design choices you can make. Traditionally, you would make something similar to, say, a 5x5 grid that is 2 units high. But you can change this to alter the speed of your rounds. In this case, the size of your arena matters. For example, an 8x8 grid that is 3 units high. If you want the players to have more freedom to build, consider making the map larger. Or think about what happens when the box area is smaller in size on the ground but higher, so they must learn how to build vertically. When designing a box fight, you'll need some basic parts. On top of your player spawn, you'll need to place a barrier that is as high as the box is wide and deep as you want. Now that you're here, open the barrier settings menu and set up whatever style you like. For this example, choose the blue force field. How does the battle start? It's simple. Grab the timed objective from the devices section and place it near your level. On completion, have your timer transmit to the barrier and bring it down. Weapons? Yeah, you'll probably need those. Once the box is set, you'll need to determine what inventory players will start with. The starting loadout determines how players eliminate each other and will change the skill level required to be competitive. Consider what might happen if you started them out with a single weapon and no potions. Or what if you changed it up and gave them access to multiple weapons, shield potions, and unlimited building resources? To do this, get a team setting an inventory pad from devices and place it on the map out of the play area, like on the roof or out of view. Set it up for team 1 and load your inventory with the weapons, ammo, materials, and any consumables you want. Then trap them on the team pad. Great! Now your players will have stuff to use in their fight. Repeat this for all the other teams. Or don't, and see what happens. In Battle Royale, new weapons are added and older ones are removed each season. So consider keeping your island updated with the newer weapons to keep it fresh. Maybe rotate the weapons weekly to a different type, such as only shotguns or melee, to attract players back to your island. Consider making multiple copies of your arena and assigning players to them each round. Make sure to keep track of the eliminations for each player. Fun fact, you can allow spectating when the players have been eliminated or allow it in general for players who want to watch. Design your arenas using transparent walls and lay them out side by side, so players can watch multiple matches at once. This game mode has everything: building defenses, weapons, cute outfits, and of course, the ability to destroy and be destroyed.